If you are watching this episode, I'll go with the assumption that you have finished all the above episodes, and the reason I say this is, somewhere in the middle, I made a couple of episodes which explicitly focused on where all can we plug a lightning component. And just to give you a basic recap, a lightning component can be plugged as a lightning tab, or a lightning component can be embedded as a utility bar item. And if you don't know what utility bar or utility bar item is, utility bar always sticks to the bottom of the browser, and you'll always have it somewhere here. And a utility bar will have multiple utility bar items, and we can plug lightning components into utility bar items, whereas we cannot plug Visual Force pages into utility bar items. Also, we can plug lightning components into the record detail page, which is a page like this, and we can also have lightning components as quick actions somewhere here. Likewise, we can also use lightning components in communities and etc. Apart from this, we can also plug lightning components into Visual Force pages, and the vice versa of that is also possible, which is plugging Visual Force pages into lightning components. The reason I say this is, the following couple of sessions will be focused on this aspect of embedding Visual Force pages into lightning components and vice versa, which is embedding lightning components into Visual Force pages. So if you see this, this is actually a Visual Force page, but then this kind of tricks us into believing that this is a lightning component, but no, this is not. This is a Visual Force page. Let me open this up. So this is the actual Visual Force page, and you can see the URL, which is something.visual.force.com/apex/name of the Visual Force page. So I applied lightning style sheets, and I made sure that this Visual Force page is rendered as lightning component. And then I kind of embedded that Visual Force page into this record page by using lightning app builder. So the problem that we'll be looking into is, whenever a Visual Force page is embedded in Lightning Experience, then this Visual Force page will be actually rendered in an iframe. Let me quickly open this sucker up. And when you navigate back to this section, you'll find an iframe here. So the actual Visual Force page is rendered in an iframe. Whereas if you try to render or plug a lightning component into a Visual Force page, then it will not be rendered in an iframe. So the problem I see with this iframe is, there is something called cross-origin resource sharing policy. So what this policy actually states is, when there are multiple web pages which are rendered from different domains altogether, then resource sharing between these two domains is almost impossible. This is actually a security measure. If you ask me in what way this is a security measure, then I would put it this way. What if I publish an App Exchange app with some malicious code in it? And what if I entice you to install the app and plug the Visual Force page into your Lightning experience? And what if I eavesdrop your data and send it maybe to my other server, or maybe use it for other harmful purposes? So in such scenarios, cross-origin resource sharing comes into picture. This is enforced by the browser. And what this states is, when there are multiple web pages from different domains, then resource sharing between them is almost impossible. So when we come back to our use case, which is, when a Visual Force page is rendered, it is rendered in an iframe, and the domain from which this Visual Force page will be rendered will be of the format something.visual.force.com, whereas the actual lightning experience will be rendering from the domain which is something.lightning.force.com. So since we are dealing with two different domains here, resource sharing between these two domains or data transfer between these two domains is almost impossible. But however, we have a workaround for it. Using that workaround, we can make sure that data transfer happens between these two domains seamlessly, and that is what we'll be looking at in the coming sessions. So that's all for this session, and stay tuned.